I'm Henry Blake, and I'm writer-director of County Lines.
Henry, it's amazing to have you here with us at the BFI London Film Festival. What does it mean for you to showcase the film as part of this celebration of cinema?
Well, this London is the film's spiritual home. So this is only right that this is the world premiere. And given the subject matter, given the story, I think it's a very fitting place and location. So the synopsis is that we really focus on a mother and son, and the son, Tyler, gets groomed and exploited by County Lines. And a County Line is a drug network that runs nationally across the country, which is a national crisis which is going on in the country right now. So alongside my filmmaking, I've been a youth worker for 11 years. And I've worked with young people directly involved in County Lines and either mentored or done workshops with them, but have sort of firsthand seen the trauma and the exploitation that County Lines causes.
Obviously, when you're telling a story like this, there's a lot of weight on the shoulders of your young star. Can you talk about the casting process to find your central lead?
I mean, Aisha Bywater's the casting director. It's credit to her. She auditioned hundreds of young boys, and we whittled it down, and then Conrad Khan simply was the most interesting and the best actor for the job. So he's a real find, and when he walked in the room on the very first casting, my instinct knew. It just knew. I was like, this kid is very, very special.
The look and feel of the film is really a major character in this story, in making this world feel real. Can you talk a little bit about the production challenges of that and that aspect of the storytelling for you?
Location selection is always very important. So establishing the family flat, getting that right, getting all the details right of that flat was really arduous, but very important to me because I've been inside those flats. And then trying to find a stark, atmospheric, but poetic location outside of London that did the trips justice was quite a tough gambit. But, you know, we got there. It's a low budget film, so everyone is down to every penny. And then, you know, we make it work. You have to think outside the box. You have to think clinically. You have to think very methodically. And you have to get what you need, not what you want. And that's the difference, is I didn't have time to get what I wanted. I had time to get what I needed. And I think that's why the film feels so economical, so lean, and so tight. And I'm proud of that, you know. I think probably the acceptable loss speech summarizes the idea behind the film, which is about vulnerability being exploited. So that we open on that. So we're quite bold in how we set up the ethical and intellectual debate of the film. But also I think one of the moments for me that is most poignant is when Tyler gets out of the car and then a girl gets in the car. And I think what that to me is about the conveyor belt nature of exploitation which County Lines inhabits. So this isn't just boys, this isn't just girls, it's organized, systemic, and very, very specific crime that is occurring in this country. And that moment for me is a personal favorite. I mean, it can be an issue film, but then you've got to watch it. And then you've got to make your decision. I think the film inhabits an issue in an unexpected and powerful way. I think there's an element of empathy and intimacy to the film and its characterization that is probably a bit surprising for people who are expecting to walk into an issue-based film. And I think that's what's interesting and very singular about the work, is that it feels unique and it feels sophisticated and it feels specific. And I think it's about intimacy and intimacy of that vulnerability, which maybe is more about the characters rather than the issue. That's how I feel.
I'm Ashley Medekwi and I play Tony in County Lines.
It's amazing to have you here with us at the BFI. Can you start by telling us what it was about this script overall that most spoke to you as a storyteller?
There was such an emotional connection to the script from the first time reading it. Henry's really good at highlighting the human cost of drug trafficking. He doesn't glamorize it at all, and sometimes there can be a danger with films in this world to glamorize that, and I think Henry did a really good job of not. So straight away I wanted to be involved.
I think obviously this concept of County Lines, it's an unknown epidemic in this country. Can you talk a little bit about what you think is going to shock an audience the most about this true story, inspired true story?
I think that the fact that it's underreported is crazy to me, because it's 10,000 children daily. Like, that's a mind-boggling number, and we're not talking about it. I think people will be shocked to see what the children go through. It's pretty hardcore.
You're here for County Lines, if you can take your seats, please.
And obviously, Henry, your director, standing beside you at the moment. Can you talk about what makes him so special as a storyteller, your experience working with him on this?
Thank you.
He is so enthusiastic. Working with him was a real treat. It's infectious being with him on set. He's excited for every single moment and every single scene. And he's really great about highlighting the emotional language between each character. He was like, when we got there each day, he would talk through each day. He would have more notes than I would.
Talking about those relationships, can you talk about working with the younger members of the cast? Because obviously this is very heavy subject matter to be exploring at their young age.
Well, Conrad himself was 18 at the time when we were shooting, so we were less careful with him. But with Tabitha, we had to be careful. There were some scenes that she would shoot her coverage separately from us, and that was, I think, important to everyone there, that we protected her innocence in a way. She's a great actress, so instinctual.
Talk about location, because it's such a huge character throughout the film.
We shot mostly on location in Camden, but also in and around London, and yeah, the flat in particular where we shot our scenes was very real. It just highlights it, what's really going on, where people are really living. I don't see this as an issue film. For me, what attracted me to the part of Tony was her relationship with her son, first and foremost. I saw it as a relationship drama more than anything else, and that's what real life is. We all have issues, and that's what makes the film interesting for me.
My final question, what does it mean for you to be showcasing the film here as part of the BFI London Film Festival?
It means the world to be here in London. I'm a London girl. I haven't lived here for a few years. So to be back here, premiering a film, set in London, shot in London, yeah, it means the world.